glasses off for this intro.
Superman!
Yes.
Hi friends, I'm Kat, and today we're gonna talk about something that is very similar to something that I think you already know. It's called analysis of means, and it sounds a lot like analysis of variance, but it's not quite the same thing. And in fact, it has a close relationship with Shewhart charts as well. So let's talk about analysis of means, or ANOM. Here's an example of a graph that shows the mean of some measurements and standard deviations, and they're plotted in such a way that we've connected the points together. We're seeing test one, and we see control limits. What's going on here? Well, what's wrong with this picture? Do you see anything wrong with this? Because I do. The problem with this picture is that this subgroup index down here is not sequential. We have the points connected as if it's sequential. We're using control limits as if these are rational subgroups from a sequential process, but in fact, they're not. These are measurements taken from different operators. And what I'd really like to know is whether any of these operators' measurements are substantially different than the rest. So that kind of sounds like an analysis of variance goal, but I've got 30 operators, or I might have 100 operators, I might have 200 operators, and I want to know whether there are any of these operators that are standouts, either very high or very low. And the problem is that here I've done this using a Shewhart chart, when really I need a different technique. So analysis of means, or ANOM, is a graphical and statistical technique. It's primarily a graphical technique for simultaneously comparing lots of different treatment means to an overall grand mean at some specified significance level alpha. And that analysis of means process uses, instead of control limits, it uses something called decision limits based on your alpha, which by default would be 0.05. But the thing is, that 0.05 is your experiment-wise alpha. It's accounting for how many comparisons you're making. So the difference between ANOVA and ANOM, you know, they're very similar, they're related, but they're not quite the same. You've already seen it's kind of like a Shewhart chart because it looks like Shewhart data, but it's not a Shewhart chart. With ANOVA, you're trying to determine whether there's a statistically significant difference among group means. So you have these different groups, you compute the mean, you compute the variability within the groups, you compare that to the between group variability, and it tells you there's a difference somewhere. Where? Well, then you got to do additional comparisons for that. On the other hand, analysis of means does not give you that overall omnibus F-test. Instead, what it does is it identifies groups whose means are significantly different from the overall or the grand mean. When we compare Shewhart charts to ANOM, Shewhart charts are used to evaluate the consistency of a process over time, while ANOM charts are used to identify groups whose means are significantly different from the grand mean. Shewhart charts make decisions about the control of the process using control limits that are usually set to plus or minus 3 sigma, where ANOM makes decisions about differences among specific groups using decision limits that are based on a significance level and the sample size. And usually we might use a significance level of 0.05. And with Shewhart charts, you are distinguishing between special and common cause variation. And you might do that with Western Electric rules, with the test for special causes, or just by looking at whether any of those points are outside of the control limits. So decision limits, control limits, that's the big difference between that's one of the big differences between an ANOM and a Shewhart chart. So what kind of ANOM are you using? Well, this goes back to the same question tree that we had when we talked about Shewhart charts in that video that hopefully the HTML fairies will put a link to the Shewhart chart videos around here somewhere. We're looking at the difference between measurement data and attribute data. If you have measurement data, typically it's grouped measurement data, there is an X chart statement that you would use in PROC ANOM. If you have attribute data, then you need to consider whether the attribute data represents more of a binomial counting process or more of a Poisson counting process. For binomial data, you would use a P chart statement, and for Poisson data, you would use a U chart statement. Now I'm in SAS, I'm going to show you an example. This example uses a data set called payout, and I'm going to give you a quick preview of the data set payout. So I have different providers. These are healthcare providers, and they're just numbered in this case. And I have time, I do have months, so we could look at this as a Shewhart problem, but in our case, we're not going to. We're just going to look at the providers, and we're going to look at the payout amounts. And so we're going to take the average payout for provider 101, the average payout for provider 102, and so forth. And in our ANOM procedure for the data set payout, which, by the way, you can get the data set from a link down below, I'm using the X chart statement because payout, it's a measurement variable. It's continuous. I can measure it out to decimal places, and it's payout by provider and then alpha equals 0.05. Super easy code. It took me about 15 seconds to write that code. And once you've written that code, you've got your ANOM output. And what do I find? Well, first of all, I have this observation right here, number 120. Provider number 120 is getting paid significantly less than the grand mean of payouts. The mean payout is 5,015.2, and this one is considerably lower. I also have two different providers up here who are significantly higher. Their payouts are much, much higher than the others. So this is a really quick and easy way to be able to see if you have some group means that are significantly greater than the overall average. It identifies them graphically. Of course, in addition to this, you can save out a table that shows you where the exceptions are so you can identify exactly which provider that is. It shows you a legend at the bottom saying the sample size is 12. If we had varying sample sizes, we would see those decision limits vary as you go across different providers. All the stuff you would expect to see. Really handy little procedure if you've never used it before. I hope you'll check it out. So if you liked this video, give me a thumbs up, put a like at the bottom of the video. Also go down there and write me a comment. Let me know, are you trying out PROC ANOM? What have you tried it with? What are some things you can think of where you'd really love to be able to identify some groups that are significantly different from the overall mean? There's some resources down below, some links to the documentation and to some training and other good stuff. And don't forget, if you like this video and other things like it, subscribe to the SAS Users channel. All right, it's been fun, and I'll see you next time.